Today we are learning two column cash book. This credit balance in bank account. Credit balance in bank account means bank overdraft. Credit balance in bank account means overdraft. In cash account there is no chance of overdraft, but in bank there is chance of overdraft. Okay. Did you write the heading?
Yes, sir.
Right. Two column cash book with it. Credit balance in bank overdraft. Credit balance in bank. Credit balance in bank. Bank overdraft. In that case, payment made through bank will be more than the amount available in the bank. It is not possible in all cases. It is not given to all customers. Customers who are in, who are having good transaction, who are in good terms with the bank, having sound balance in every month, for those customers only bank will be giving this facility. It's not available for each and every customer. And that also up to a certain limits. Suppose you are running a business and you are having an account with State Bank of India. Example, bank is giving you OD facility up to 1 lakh rupees. What's the meaning? You can spend more than the available balance. Available balance may be 5,000. But he can spend up to how much amount? What is the effect
one
of
lakh. OD?
Are you understanding? I understand very clearly. What is the effect of OD? It means overdraft. What is the effect of OD? We can spend more than the available balance. We can spend more than the
available balance.
You learn practically, you are going to become accountant, or you will be shining in some accounts field, finance field. Even if you don't want to work under anybody, when you are starting a business, these aspects are very much important. And this effect we should underline and understand through example. Suppose available balance from AB is rupees 5,000 only. And bank is giving the OD facility you are enjoying is 1 lakh. That means you can spend 1 lakh rupees more. That's the meaning. We can spend up to 1,05,000 rupees. Okay. Payment can be made up to rupees 1,05,000 rupees. You are already having only 5,000. Bank is giving you OD facility. If OD is 1 lakh rupees, you can spend up to 1,05,000 rupees. Suppose your available balance is 7,000 rupees. OD facility given by the bank is 50,000 rupees. You can spend up to how much amount?
57,000.
So that's the meaning, which is very simple to understand. All the practical aspect in accountancy we have to touch. Are you writing this? Effect of OD?
Yes, sir.
So when you finish,
tell me. Sir, writing, sir.
Okay, if you are writing, write and tell me.
completed, sir.
All. Everybody completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now we will learn how to prepare cash book with cash and bank. Okay. You will practice a simple problem. Right, prepare. Prepare. Two column cash book. Prepare two column cash book. Prepare two column cash book. Transaction. First May 2020. Started business with the cash. It's 3 lakh. Started business with the cash. 3 lakh. So reserve space for the question. We will do answer also parallelly so that you will understand. No need of confusion. You can avoid confusion if you are practicing along with the question. Okay. Give the heading cash book.
Yes, sir.
So in a cash book with the cash and bank column. Cash book in bracket you can write?
Two column.
Two column cash book or double column cash book? Your wish. Both are right. What's a specialty? Whatever a specialty. Amount column will be extra. Extra amount column on both sides. One extra amount column. Okay. On. Cash column and bank column. This is bank debit. This is cash debit. This is debit side. This is credit side. Cash bank. Just like a key account system. Start the business with the cash. How it will appear in cash book?
Sir, in the cash account, in the debit side, two capital, sir.
Yes. Capital. lakh rupees. June 20. How the entry will appear in cash book? Deposited into bank rupees 1 lakh. Deposited into bank rupees 1 lakh. How it will come?
So the board is not appearing, sir. Your voice is breaking, sir.
So the entry will appear in bank cash book. It's a general entry for this bank account debit to.
Bank account debit to cash account.
Yes. So how it will appear in cash book?
Sir, in the bank account to cash, sir, and debit side, sir. Then in the credit side, cash it by bank account, sir.
Yes. So in cash column, we will write 1 lakh.
By rupees 1 lakh, sir.
It's called a contra entry in accountancy. Contra entry, appearing on both sides. What is contra entry? Amount is appearing on?
Appearing in the both.
Both side, contra entry.
Appearing on both.
Yes. In bank column, in bank account we are writing to cash. Same amount we are writing in cash account as by bank. July 10th, 2020 purchase. Goods, simply purchased goods, 70,000. Simply purchased goods means, is it cash purchase or credit purchase?
Cash purchase.
Yes. So what will be general entry?
Cash account debit to. So no, sir. Purchase account debit to cash account.
Purchase account debit to cash. Purchase account debit to cash. So how it will appear in cash book?
So 1 minute. So what is the amount, sir?
70,000.
Sir, date, sir.
10th July. Adjust the camera. 10th July.
Sir, in this credit side, cash account by purchase will come, sir. Rupees 70,000.
Yes. By purchase account. 70,000.
Rupees 70,000.
Yes. Then. Eleven seven 20 credit purchase. Rupees 1,50,000. Credit purchase, rupees 1,50,000. How it will appear in cash book?
Sir, 11th July, sir.
11th July, yes. 11th July.
Sundry creditors account debit to cash account.
Why? Purposefully I give this question. This transaction. What is that, journal entry? For testing your knowledge, I give this transaction.
Sir, sundry creditors.
What is the journal entry for credit purchase?
Account debit to cash account.
Okay, any other students? That is Kavishri's answer. Any other student?
Purchase account. So, purchase account debit to sundry creditors.
Yes. So, why I give this question for testing your knowledge only? This entry will come in cash book or not, children? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the journal entry? Say once again.
Purchase account debit to.
Purchase account debit to.
Sundry creditors.
Come, sir.
Tell me. Whether this entry will come in cash account or not. Cash book means cash account only, children. Cash book means cash account only.
No, sir.
Yes or no? It will come or not?
This cash is not involved, sir. They're credited, sir. They will be later only, sir. So that cash is not involved, sir.
Yes, cash is not involved. So it will come or not? It will come in the cash book or not?
No, sir, it will not come, sir.
Yes, for testing your knowledge, I give. In exam also, this kind of tricky question will be there. Be careful. It will not come in cash account or bank account. Fine. Okay. 1st October 2020. 1st October 2020. Paid check or issued check. Issued check to sundry creditors. 1,50,000. 1,40,000. 1,40,000. What is a trans journal entry for this?
Sundry creditors account debit to bank account.
Sundry creditors account debit to bank account.
Bank account.
Sundry creditors to bank.
So that in the bank account by sundry creditors account.
Yes. By sundry creditors. How much? In bank only. 140.
Yes, 1,40,000.
Here something happened in bank account. What is happened? Can you guess? Something special is happened in bank account. What is that?
Bank balance is decreasing, sir.
It is not only decreasing. Bank balance is no bank balance. It is turned into OD. Minus balance. You can say?
Minus balance.
Or we can say credit balance. One more word is there. OD. OD means?
Overdraft.
Three words we are using.
Overdraft.
When you are working as an accountant, be familiar with these three words. What are the three words, children? Minus balance. What is the other word? Credit balance. Other word?
Minus balance, credit balance.
One more word is there, no?
OD.
OD. So when we are writing balance, carry down, balance go down, be careful. Now, you know what are the steps for posting, balancing, posting our. So what's the step number one? Leave one line, right? Leave one line.
Yes, sir. Leave one line. Write the greatest.
Yes, write the greater amount on both sides.
Write the greatest total on both sides, sir.
Okay, if it is easy.
And write the difference amount on
lesser side. And last, we will write the same amount on the opposite side. All of them. It's very simple only.
On the opposite side, amount brought down.
Number of very many number of steps are given in the book. And the Maria Lam, but it will take more time. You will be in confusion. Be practical. So after leaving one line, write in the greater total. Which is a greater total? One by one. Cash separates, bank separates. So by looking debit side of cash account and credit side of cash account, which is more? This 1,70,000 here, 3 lakh, which is more?
Credit.
Credit side, sir.
Obviously, he is saying credit side is more. Any other students? 2-3 students? After getting answer from 2-3 students, I will come to the conclusion. Kavishri is saying credit side
sir,
is
no,
more.
Sir, I written 1,40,000 in the cash side, sir. Debit side is more, sir.
Okay, debit
I
side.
I wrote the 1,40,000 in the cash side.
That's the reason. 1,40,000 is not, it's not in the cash, and we should write in the bank.
Bank.
Okay, greater amount, 3 lakh. The same amount we will write on both sides of that account. Of that account. And the Madhuri, so try to balance this first. Otherwise, you will be in trouble. Yeah, we just started this topic only. First, you balance this account. What's the next step? Write the balance on the lesser side.
In the opposite side.
Here, lesser side, balance for now. After writing, balance CD. Carry down.
By balance.
By looking, if you CD, can understand. If you can, 30,000. If you know the difference, it's okay. If you want to calculate, you can calculate somewhere. Don't do the calculation in the answer. Your mark will be reduced. In some other place, you can do. So advised, it is advised to do the calculation on the bottom. Suppose this is a F or C. Do it on the bottom. Because doing on the side is possible in mathematics, but in accountancy, the space required for accounts and financial statements is more. So we cannot write anything on the margin. Writing on the margin is prohibited in accountancy. It's not possible also. Already it is congested, will be congested. Again, if you are writing on any margin, then it is doesn't look nice. In accountancy, it is advised to write on the bottom. Any calculation. 3 lakh minus total of this. What's the total of these two figures?
30,000, sir.
What is the total of these two figures? Total of these two figures.
Sir, the difference is 30,000, sir.
What is the total of these two figure? 1,70,000.
3 lakh.
Are you in the class or you are doing some other work?
Sir, in the class, sir.
I am asking what is the total of these two figures? One figure 1 lakh, another figure 70,000.
1 lakh 70,000.
1 lakh 70,000, right? That yes, figure sir. Is to be deducted from 3 lakh. You can do the calculation.
1 lakh 30,000.
1 lakh 30,000, right?
Yes, sir.
Step number 3 over. That's the last step in balancing. Write the same amount on the.
And then in the opposite side.
Below total.
By balance brought down.
Opposite side below total. Opposite side means this side only, right? Below the total. This is a total. Are you seeing? This is a total. Below the total. Here only you have to write. Isn't it? Yes. Balance brought down. Against that. Exactly against that we have to write. Exactly again, sir, we have right balance brought down. Whatever we are writing on the left side,
balance,
we should start with the prefix to balance brought down. Cash account mudinjachu appra innum irukku edhe bank account. Careful, this minus balance. So which is greater side, children?
Credit side.
That amount we will write on both
debit
side. Credit side dot 1 lakh 40,000. Debit side 1 lakh. Which side is more?
Credit side.
So,
but that is in as a credit.
Debit side.
That is a credit balance, no, sir. 1 lakh 40,000. 40,000 is a credit balance, no, sir.
What is the rule of balancing? Anybody can say what's the rule of balancing? Write step number 1. Write the greater total on both sides. Step number 1. Here, debit side total 1 lakh. Credit side total 1 lakh 40,000. Which is greater?
1 lakh 40,000.
That amount is 140. Greater amount on both sides. Step number 2. Difference on lesser side. Difference, write the difference on lesser side. How much is the difference? Debit, whatever figure than it. Debit side total 1 lakh. Credit side total 1 lakh 40,000. How much is the difference?
40,000.
40,000. That 40,000 we should write in debit or credit. Write on the lesser side. In bank account, the lesser debit side is debit only, right?
Debit.
Am I right or not? The bank account, lesser yes, side sir. Is not credit. Lesser side is debit only. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So we will write here 40,000. And what we should write against is 40,000 to.
We have to write in the opposite side, credit side down.
We are overtaking. What I am asking you, what you are saying, not matching. Step number 1, we wrote the greater amount on both sides. Step number 2, write the difference on lesser side. Lesser side is debit side, 40,000. By writing to balance carry down, to balance carry down. Step number 3 over. Step number 4. Write the same amount on the opposite side below total. So we write here by balance brought down below total, below the bank column, 40,000. I prefer to do one more question so that you will be confident. If time permits, time is only over. Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
We will practice one more question in the next period. We have one more period at 11 o'clock. Okay. Same topic, we will practice one more question. Did you complete this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
At 11 o'clock.